Do you and your team sometimes struggle to actually apply AI coding in your daily work? Good news! I'm Jonas from EclipseSource, and I have a solution for you. We all know these shiny YouTube videos and articles about the latest prompting tricks, about techniques like context engineering and the whole vibe coding hype. However, as you might have experienced yourself, if we want to apply these techniques on an evolved code base and potentially in an enterprise setting, this vibe coding magic often enough fails. And that's not because these techniques are bad. There are incredibly useful building blocks out there. What's really missing here is the bigger picture, a workflow, a pragmatic methodology that combines all these building blocks into a reliable and repeatable process that you can apply every day to every AI coding task you're working on. The good news is we got you covered on this. At EclipseSource, for over 2 years, we tried every prompting trick, every new AI coding tool. We struggled, we learned, and ultimately we identified the missing piece, a repeatable workflow, a pragmatic methodology, the glue that puts everything together, and that's what we call Dibe Coding. Now, before we dive into the details for the impatient, if you want to learn Dibe Coding, the repeatable way to successfully apply AI coding in your day-to-day work, we now have an online training available. Dibe Coding and the online training are both tool agnostic, so you can use any tool of your choice, maybe GitHub Copilot, Cursor, Cloud Code, whatever you want to use. You can learn at your own pace and consume the lessons as you want. And for watchers of this video, we grant an additional 10% discount in addition to the early access discount. So be fast, grab the link down in the description and the code and book the Dibe Coding online training right now. Now, let's look at a few examples on how Dibe Coding can help you with AI coding. Most of the material you find in the internet about AI coding is about preparing the perfect prompt and maybe even how to prompt it to the AI. However, that's a little bit about talking how to set up your paraglider and maybe even how to start, but completely ignoring how to fly. And that's not good, right? Because it's not only about preparing, it's also about flying and knowing what to do after launching your paraglider. To talk about a very concrete example, let's imagine you've prompted an AI coding agent and you're unhappy with the result. Now, most other videos don't talk about that because they assume with their perfect techniques and tools, you never get to this state. But in reality, you of course will get there. So what do most developers do? The most obvious option is to do a refine, and that means writing another chat message to ultimately get to the state where you want. And that might work for minor tweaks. But if you're very far away from your desired result, this leads to a very long chat, polluted context, and ultimately you might just get down into an endless rabbit hole. In Dibe Coding, we do not just stop at context engineering and prompting. We also cover the part that is usually the most work, and that's reviewing and refining the results of AI code generation. And writing another chat message for refinement is by far not the only option. In the training, we guide you through a concrete set of follow-up actions you can choose from. Using practical examples, we show you when to choose which options to make your process repeatable and reliable, and ultimately get you to the final result as efficient as possible. And the simplest example of these follow-up techniques I can mention here in the video is a redo. And what that means is instead of writing another chat message, you go back to your initial prompt and tweak it, make it better, and basically remove the things that have led to an imperfect result and just run the generation again. That's often overlooked, but it keeps your context clean. When we go back to the paragliding example, this would mean if you didn't have a perfect start, you just go to the ground again and do the start again. This is not possible in reality, but in AI coding it is. And it's a very, very useful and simple example for a follow-up action. Of course, there are more complex ones that we explain in detail in the training. Another thing that I would like to highlight about Dibe Coding is that it's tool agnostic, and it also covers aspects that have nothing to do with tools. A good example for this is the concept of task engineering, which plays a central role in the Dibe Coding process. While many resources out there focus on context engineering, which means for a given task, prepare the perfect context and information to prompt the AI with, we also consider the task itself. Is it a task that is suitable to be delegated, or does it need reshaping? And that can mean changing the task or, for example, dividing it into subtasks. And it's actually surprising how much you can actually increase the efficiency and reliability of AI code generation by just shaping the task a little bit. We discuss that in detail, of course, in the training. The last advantage of the Dibe coding methodology I would like to mention in this video is the value of a basic and common structure. We observed that teams adopting Dibe coding have a much easier time to communicate about their workflows, about the techniques they apply, and basically share their experience and their knowledge to learn from each other. And while Dibe coding provides concrete techniques for every step in the workflow, it's also a very flexible process. You can adopt new techniques, new tools, and basically plug them into a workflow. And we observed in practice that teams that adopted Dibe coding have a much easier time optimizing their process step by step whenever something new is discovered. The training covers the full workflow from start to end. We use a lot of practical examples and demonstrations to really give you an impression how AI coding works in practice and make it easy for you to adapt it to your own work. The training will also give you a basic understanding on how AI coding agents work. This understanding, in our experience, is very important to be able to write better prompts, provide better context, and also understand why certain runs with AI coding agents fail and what to do about it. The training can be consumed online at your own pace, wherever you are. Watchers of this video get an additional 10% discount in addition to the early access phase. So be fast, grab the code down in the description, and you also find the link and get the training now. And finally, if you're interested in deploying the training for a larger group of people, or you need a formal quotation or anything else to get the training, get in contact with us. We got you covered. And with that, thank you for watching this video. Leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more news, and hopefully have fun with the Dibe coding methodology.